Hello, and today we are with Mr. Brent Martin, who is the General Manager of the Four Seasons Resort Koh Samui. Good afternoon to you, Mr. Martin.
Good afternoon.
Now, Four Seasons Hotel, you're just about to celebrate your fifth anniversary. How have the last 5 years been for you?
It's been an incredible ride here at Four Seasons Resort Koh Samui. We opened 5 years ago in the midst of the really growth in the market. And now we've seen a lot change, obviously, in the past 5 years. But we were very fortunate to be one of the first luxury hotels in Koh Samui. And so in that time, we've seen a lot of changes in the island, a lot of very positive things. And so we're proud to be a part of that.
Right. Now, being the Four Seasons is good and bad, in the sense that when a guest does stay at your property, they expect the highest of the highest quality. There's only a handful of hotels where you would expect that. How do you manage to accomplish that when there is so much competition, both from a rate level and also a hardware level as well?
Well, we're lucky. Being a part of Four Seasons, we've had 50 years of incredible service. So we've built up that. And that's not just the reputation we've built that up, but we've built up the services, the operations, the things that support that. So, when we opened 5 years ago, we opened with a team of experienced hoteliers, with the local people joining the team. And so from the beginning, we really hit the mark. And the combination of Four Seasons service with that special spot that we have in Koh Samui has really made what the guests expect from Four Seasons.
Right. Now, you have a different selection of room categories and what have you, and also villas as well. How exactly have you broken down the room categories at the resort?
For us at the resort, we are only a villa product. So we have 61 bedroom villas, all with swimming pools, all with views. So I say it's a very simple resort in that way. But we have several categories of rooms, ones with some smaller pools, about 15 square meters, and then a larger pool with about 30 square meters. And then a few more categories that are based on location, at the beach or higher up in the hillside. We also are very fortunate at the resort to have residences. So those are two bedrooms, three bedrooms, up to five bedrooms. And so those are an incredible experience, three, four bedrooms with a large swimming pool, living room, dining area, and the live-in butler service.
Yeah, I mean, how many of those residences do you have?
14 of those.
14 in total. And what would the average length of stay be at the resort, both for the residences and the villas themselves?
Usually it's around 4 to 5 nights. And that's really our combination because we have both markets now over the past 5 years. We have both the regional market, which is shorter length of stay of 2 to 3 nights, then combined with the long haul destinations being more like 7 or 10. So you get an average around 4 or 5.
Right. And in terms of guest demographics, who is it that chooses to stay at the Four Seasons?
Surprisingly enough, for Koh Samui, our number one source of guests is the United States. And historically it was the United Kingdom, but now that's really changed. We now have a mix of just about everything. With the US being only 15% of the market, it's not a large number, so everything else is between 5 and 10%. That can be Northern European, it could be German, sometimes in years it could be Russian, it could be Korean. So really it's a nice mix.
Right. Now, obviously, when it comes down to service, language is not only language, but also the understanding of a certain culture is very important. And obviously, within the region, you have the Japanese, the Chinese, the Koreans, the Eastern European blocs and what have you. How are you accommodating them in terms of language and service as well?
We take each one of the markets and really dig down. We're fortunate with 87 properties around the world that we have hotels in many locations. So we use our brethren around the world and say, what do the guests need from your market? And so, most recently with the strong growth of the Chinese market, we've developed a program for our Chinese guests. What do they want in the room? What do they want in the restaurants? Getting the menus in Chinese if appropriate, or whatever it is, because some nationalities need language for menus, some don't. Some would rather have it in the local language or in English, and some want to be tailored to them. So we do that for each of the nationalities, whether it's Japanese, whether it's Korean. We do it for everybody.
Right. Now, being on the hillside, it means obviously you have great views from some of the villas, but it also means that you need to be slightly athletic, one would say. How do you address this issue of being on a hillside?
Well, like you said, all 60 of our villas plus the 14 residents, everybody has a view. So you don't have to worry about, are you going to get in a villa that doesn't have a view? We all do have views. We do have a hillside. There is no elevator, so we have to go up and down the hill, but we have buggy service. We have 42 golf carts that are on property to take our guests around. They never have to wait more than 5 or 10 minutes wherever they'd like to go. Usually it's much less than that. So those who don't want to walk can use the buggy service.
Right. Now, where, for those that don't know Koh Samui very well, where is your property?
So the island, we are in the northwest corner of the island. The airport is in the northeast corner. So we're just right across the top. It's about a 20-25 minute drive from the airport over to the resort.
Right. And do you offer shuttle buses into, for example, some of the more popular or busy areas of Koh Samui?
Well, it's interesting. We've looked at that over the years. But what's ironic about our guests is they come and they never leave. So they come into the resort, and some come off that plane from New York and say, what am I going to do at 10 o'clock, 12 o'clock, 2 o'clock? And then after 24 hours, they're like, I'm not going to be doing anything. And that's really what we find our guests. They rarely go out, so there really isn't a need for the shuttle would be empty. So we don't offer a shuttle service. Over into Chuang is about 25 minutes, so there's taxi service, or at Fisherman's Village, which is 20 minutes away.
All right, excellent. Now, of course, when you say something like that, when people don't leave the resort, it always makes me wonder a little bit about the F&B outlets of the hotel and whether they take advantage of guests. You are the Four Seasons. It's not going to be cheap. But what F&B outlets do you have, and how would you regard their pricing?
Well, it's interesting. We continually look at that just to make sure we are competitive, because for me, if the guests leave the resort, we've made them leave. Because they really want to stay in the resort. So if we make our prices unattractive, they will leave. And so we've captured pretty much 95% of every guest to stay in the resort. So we know the prices are competitive. They know what the price of Thai food is. And so we always keep all of our pricing competitive. In terms of options, we have many different options. We offer Italian, we offer Thai, we offer Mediterranean, so many different things to keep them interested, as well as some private personalized experiences.
Right. Now, one of the nicest things about any Four Seasons hotel in the world is obviously the bedding. It's something you as a company are very, very proud of. You being only 5 years old, you must have some of the latest technology when it comes to the bedding and the bed sheets. Could you tell us a little bit about what makes the Four Seasons bed, especially your resort, so special?
Well, you're right. Four Seasons over the past 15, 20 years have constantly looked at the bed because it is the most important thing in the stay. And we have our own bed, the Four Seasons bed. And, you know, I had guests actually just last month who were complaining because they said, I don't get out of bed. I'm sleeping till noon because the bed is incredible. And I actually had one guest who said, I wake up every morning at home with a bad back. And I even have a special bed at home because of that. But for the first time, I am able to enjoy my vacation because I don't have that problem. So our bed is one of the newest in the development of the bed. It is actually a little more firm than it used to be. 10 years ago, they were all very soft beds. And now we realize that people need a firmness. And so we've actually now changed that bed, so it's a little more firm. And now we've also brought in another option for guests who are now used to very firm. We also have that option for them as well.
So you actually offer choices in not just with the pillows, because the pillow menu, that's standard now across every hotel, but you also offer a mattress choice.
If somebody needs a firmer one, we now have the Four Seasons bed that's firmer.
Right, and in terms of the bed sheets, I was just recently in Jakarta, 1,200 thread count. The thread count war seems to be going on among the hotels. Where are we with Four Seasons, roughly?
I don't know if I know the thread count, like you said. It keeps changing, but we've just recently throughout the Four Seasons introduced a new sheet. It's a little silkier than the ones we've had in the past, with a much more clean, contemporary look. And so you'll see that if you are at our resort. It's the new look for Four Seasons in terms of bedding.
Right. Now, of course, every hotel is trying to get as much business as they can coming in through their own website. How much of your business at the moment is coming through your own website? And how do you foresee the role of the travel agent as we move forward?
What's interesting for us in Four Seasons is we want to make sure that how a guest books were available. And it doesn't matter whether you feel more comfortable going online or calling your travel professional you've been working for 20 years. We want to make sure we have the rates available to you in both or in all outlets. And so it is our commitment to our clients to say, I don't care how you book, just as long as you book with us. And so we've seen the growth for us in the property go from about 5% of our website bookings for our own personal website to probably 15 or 20%. So we've really seen the growth. But the thing about staying with Four Seasons and our guests who stay with Four Seasons, they depend a lot on the word of mouth and professional advice. And so we still continue to see that a large amount of our business comes from travel agents, and we expect that to continue, because when you're making that investment in a holiday, you want to make sure you're staying in the best place. And of course, with Four Seasons' name, they trust it, but they also want to know, okay, which Four Seasons do I go to? Which is appropriate for my family or for my circumstance? And so we still see a lot coming from travel agents, and we'll continue to do that.
Right. And in terms of the resorts, obviously, there's not just the couples going looking for a romantic break, but there's also families and what have you. How do you cater to children at the resorts? And do you have also a children-free pool where children aren't allowed? Which direction have you decided to go?
Well, Four Seasons is family friendly. It's been our mantra for a long time. So everything we do does cater to the children. So we're not adults only. We do welcome children. And Four Seasons, as you may be aware, has a Kids for All Seasons program, which is a complimentary child care service that we offer. For us, it's from ages 2 to 12. So from 9 to 5 every day, we have professional caregivers to provide activities for children that allows the parents to actually be on vacation, have their children there with them, but they can actually have a little bit of a break. So we're very fortunate. Again, that's a complimentary service that we offer.
And what times that start and finish?
It's 9 a.m. to 5 p.m. every day.
Right.
And 65 days a year.
Right, okay. Mm-hmm. And you also do, I guess, babysitting services as well?
Yes.
In the evening. Is that something that you charge, or is that?
There is an additional fee for that.
Right, okay. Now, Koh Samui, it was first discovered in a way by backpackers. That's what it was renowned for, the cheap accommodation on beautiful beaches. And now, as you mentioned, there is Four Seasons, there's a lot of luxury properties there. Some people say that the Koh Samui is overdeveloped. How would you respond to that?
I would say that there is always a risk for any island that has been as popular as Koh Samui and the lore that grew up around it about a place to escape. We as travelers, you know, can sometimes destroy the thing that is the most special about it. But I think what's interesting about Samui is I think we've still managed to maintain the specialness that is Koh Samui, because people went to Koh Samui to get away, to find a beach that they could just do nothing. And you can still do that throughout Samui. Yes, there is Chuang, so you still have the nightlife and the restaurants and all shopping and everything, but it's all in a small area. Whereas the rest of the 95% of the rest of the island still is available what you go to Samui for, and especially for Four Seasons. We found a very special piece of land on the northwest tip that really has its own private beach, it has its jungle, it has everything that you go to Koh Samui for.
Right. Now, you mentioned earlier the average length of stay is about 4 to 5 nights.
Yes.
Koh Samui is also very popular with retirees that tend to spend a little bit longer. They're looking for monthly or a couple of months stay. Do you offer long stay packages?
We do in our residences, so if somebody would like to stay 2 weeks or 30 days. The challenge we have is many of our guests would like to, but they have the reality of their business. So we, as much as we see people wanting to stay longer, most of our guests are actually the world traveler and they don't have the opportunity to stay 30 days.
Wouldn't we all like to stay 30 days in Koh Samui, especially the Four Seasons? Yeah. But again, like you mentioned there, they are world travelers. They need to be connected as well. And there we come to the question of internet. Some hotel brands, they offer complimentary internet across all of their brands regardless of room rate. What is the policy at the Four Seasons Hotel in Koh Samui?
For us, it's an evolving standard. We are now starting to offer complimentary internet. For us, it's an interesting thing we've looked at because we have a huge infrastructure behind it. There is a cost to the internet we offer. We don't just provide you a service and say good luck. We actually have an IT specialist on property who can handle all the issues, whose focus is only IT. It's not somebody who does it as a part of his front desk job. So we actually have professionals behind it. We've also make sure our speed is at the highest level. We're actually the highest on the island. So for a while, we were charging because of the cost behind it. And that is now evolving, and we'll probably see that now go away in the next 6 months.
In the next 6 months. That's very, very good news. I'm sure that'll be a welcome thing for the travelers. And that will be, when it goes away, then people will be able to use multiple devices and what have you.
Of course. The reality today is no one comes with one device. I see families come in with 10 to 15 devices now.
Right. And finally, Koh Samui, it is a pretty much a year-round destination, but if you were to travel there twice a year, when would you recommend the best times to go to Koh Samui would be?
I would say probably, of course, the January to March time is the driest and coolest, so that's a lovely time. But I also say around July is still a special time because it's not very busy, but you still have great weather.
Excellent. Well, on that note, Mr. Dave Martin, thank you very much indeed for your time today. And, of course, have a good trip back to Koh Samui.
My pleasure to be with you today. Thank you.